So our goal when we farm is we never want to see the soil unless we go looking for it. We think this is beautiful right here. We've got all of this straw left over from the triticale crop that was harvested back in July. So in addition to this great thatch of cover that we have with this triticale residue, we planted these sunflowers in here along with the cover crop. So this is kind of a dual purpose. We're gonna harvest the sunflowers for a cash crop. I've got cow peas growing in here, Austrian winter peas, flax, we have buckwheat, we've got squash. There's about 10 different companion cover crops growing right with the sunflowers. And that's what's giving me additional soil benefits through the great diversity that I have, but I still have the opportunity to harvest a cash crop. But the root of a sunflower, it's got a massive root system. The roots are what's really helping build our soil. It's building soil structure. It's giving an environment for all of the soil microorganisms to live. Earthworms love sunflower roots. The channels that they leave behind as they burrow up and down from the surface down below, it's a great conduit for moisture to get down. Think of it as having, you know, millions of little straws. And when it rains, the water is gonna run right down those earthworm burrows. So I can take a big rain on this field and it's all gonna go into the soil. The residue is gonna slow the rain down. And then when the water gets below the residue, it's gonna find these earthworm channels and just go straight into the soil. So it's really good at helping the infiltration rates. The other thing that earthworms do is they help cycle the residue. So they'll come up, they'll grab pieces of the triticale straw, they'll grab pieces of the sunflower leaves later on, they'll pull them back down into the earthworm channels, and it will speed up the decomposition, the nutrient cycling, and things like that. So earthworms are the easiest part of the soil biology to see. It's one of the few things that are large enough that we can see, but it's all of the other ones that are too small for us to see that are really important in doing a lot of work. So anytime we can have diversity, it's a huge benefit for building soil health much, much more quickly than if we just have a monoculture. And that's why we love this type of system, because I get the best of both worlds. You know, it's kind of like having your cake and eating it too. You know, I've got the cake with the sunflowers that I'm going to harvest, but I'm eating the cake too because I've got all of the benefits of the diversity growing down underneath it. And just from the way this field looks, I think this cake is going to taste pretty good.